And that leads me to our last presentation from Paulina. Paulina is the founder of Eliorec and CEO of Eliorec. She will present you with a lot of passion the fight she's on. Go ahead.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I'm very happy to be here and talk to you about what I'm thinking about this world, what we're gonna show you. I'm founder and CEO of company Heliorec. We are building floating solar power plant, innovative and cost-effective solution of electricity production. Let me share with you a short video, and you can see what I care about three global problems, and our solution, how we can mitigate them. Voila, save the planet, save the future. As you understood, we want to mitigate three global problems: land scarcity, plastic pollution, and global warming. In frame of this conference, I would like to highlight the problem with global warming and some mitigations what has to be in the place. So if you not do anything, you see the bottom of Eiffel Tower, temperature will rise 3.4 degrees higher than pre-industrial level. This is what Mr. Patrick from Total said. So it's going to be something like that. If we implement INDC, so temperature will be around 3 degrees, so it's also not so good. Ocean will rise. And I heard that everything will be underwater and only some part of Siberia will survive. So if you have extra money, come to Siberia to buy some land. And if we will do something, like if we will do a lot from all sectors, it is still we have some time to keep temperature up to 1.5 degrees. But all sectors, every individual should put effort for this. And some steps what we have to do. So carbon pricing mechanism, I hope without corruption, maybe it will happen. I really believe that we need to subsidize and invest more in renewable energy. We need to reduce subsidies from the fossil industry. As you know, it's subsidies around 5 times more than subsidies in renewable energy, so it is really strange. We need to reduce consumption on all levels. So if you have iPhone, don't buy new iPhone because it's the latest model. Or if you already have car, so share with your husband or wife and don't buy new car. And also negative emission technologies have to be implemented. So the easiest way is to grow trees. So don't waste your time, go to grow trees at least. And all these measurements, they should be placed all together. And so this is a graph I just took this morning. If temperature will want to keep 1.5 degrees Celsius, so the carbon budget, what we're using now, so we have only 8 years, so not 11 years, it's like 8 years now to keep temperature below 1.5 degrees. It's quite short. You don't believe me. Yeah, if we want to keep temperature up to 2 degrees, we still have like at 26 years. But let's not have more risks. Don't put more risks. So, and I was invited here as a young leader, and I want to talk about my story. So all my life, more than 14 years, I worked in oil and gas industry. And at some moment, I decided that it's not normal to contribute my effort, my brain, to this industry if it is not really sustainable. So, and I decided to change my life path and my career path, and I moved to renewable energy sector. So I went to study in Germany. I got my the second master's degree in renewable energy, ocean energy. I opened my company because I want to do it in the better way. It's not about business. I want to really contribute my life to something what I really believe. And I got an award, Woman in Green Tech, the previous year. And I know maybe it's just one drop in the ocean, what I'm doing. But what is the ocean? Ocean is many drops from every of us. I did my positive drop. What about you? So, if you don't know how to do it, or if it is difficult, it's really difficult. You're like a politicians, you're in the system. It is so difficult to be different and behave differently if system is corrupted, if many lobbies there. Okay, my personal opinion or my proposal to you, if you cannot do your work good as the politicians, because we, the citizens, give you opportunity to manage our lives. If it doesn't work, so maybe do something, not as a politician, do something as a human. Use less plastic, eat less meat, use less everything. If you have money, invested in sustainable businesses, as my colleague mentioned, it can be really profitable. If you don't know what to do, ask me. I have a lot of advice. Thank you very much, and good luck with our lives.